I ain't gonna lie, I really kind of salute my fans because it's like, for an artist that been out 7 years, I only got probably like 5 or 6 tapes out. So with that math, it's like equivalent to an album a year. So it's like, for me to still have the fan base that I got, and like, it really shows a lot, or like, you know, that my fan base is really strong. Like, they really fuck with me heavy. So I really appreciate all my fans, for real. Like, for fucking with me, because I don't really drop. More like, for me, I take my time. You know, I'll probably take like 2 days to write a song, or it took me like a week to write a song before, like, so I be just telling people, like, just take your time, like, all that punch in, and you know, you really ain't putting too much thought into it. So it's like, you coming up with some mediocre shit, just if you're trying to, like, you know, some people that spot on that could just freestyle like on some Lil Wayne shit in this, feel me? But like, don't get me wrong, no, I got hits that I freestyle. I got hits that I freestyle, but most of my biggest songs, I really sat down and wrote it. Took my time with it. Hey, I trap my heart till I'm rich like fuck sleep. And in the game, why you hating from the nosebleeds? It was me, Boo Sachin, and Lil Mikey. Call my Gemini twin, yeah, that's Nani. Stay down, cause this shit don't happen overnight. They only love you when you up, so I'm catching flights. Living wrong, so the family could be living right. I bossed up on them bitches, had to up the price. I'm in a track hawk Jeep, trying to do the whole dash. And smoke ain't free when them killers, they trying to crash. Niggas ain't tough, in person, they throw flash. Keep it on the low, that's cold, we don't brag. I'm in a track hawk deep, trying to do the whole dash. One more time. Like, a lot of CEOs with the labels and shit, like, I just go from other people's experiences with major labels, and like, they really don't be too happy with their situation. And like, I could personally call Gazi, you know, with certain little shit. You know, a lot of people can't do that with their CEO. They can't just call the CEO, you know, they gotta go through people, and so. Alright, just fuck it, just do it. But I'ma just do the intro and then.
He need the type of nigga he gonna drop and he still ain't even finished it. You know what I'm saying?
I'm trying to get like that. I'm my daddy's son. This is
dangerous. I'm trying to get like
that. Hey, wait, that's how you spell it. You know what I'm saying?
I need to eat a little pocket or something. That's what I need.
Like the first one.
Yeah, like doing.
He inspired me to rap.
10 million views and shit.
I seen him going crazy. Like,
that's what I'm saying.
If he could do it, I could do it. Type yeah, shit.
I see.
But we got real history though. Like, our dads know each other. Mm-hmm. Type shit.
Yeah, we for sure look crazy. That's what I say. I definitely seen that. I'm like, damn, I really know, bro. So, for to see like a nigga really doing all them numbers and then like really getting the respect and like, you feel me, the credit for this shit that a nigga deserve, that shit was big for sure.
You definitely a real shit, man.
Definitely open doors.
Yeah.
Like, you know, now we just like push each other, like whatever we need, like get on this song. Hey, ain't even a question, like, you know what I mean? Pull up here, like you told me to pull up, I'm pulling up, that's brother, for sure. Yeah, for sure. When he seen me rapping, he was like, "Are you rapping now, bruh?" Like, bruh, go crazy. That nigga took me to the studio, Scotty Bay. We did like 2 songs together. Hitting me up.
Mm-hmm.
Bro, when is Pete gonna drop? Yeah. I'll be like, bruh, he his own. He gonna drop when he want to. He got a core fan base, crazy fan base. They gonna fuck with him whenever. That shit hella tight. Nigga been doing this for a long time, man.
And still on it, though. That's the sick part about it.
For sure.
He's got to get himself that credit, for real.
Yeah.
Because he definitely going crazy.
So we started rapping, like, 2 years after he was already Lil Pete. Like,
he was famous.
He was already big.
That's why I was shocked. I'm like, damn, bro. Like, they really fucked with that nigga. Like, that shit was sick for
real. He inspired niggas to do what we doing now. Shit too.
He got a bag. He got a bag. Pain that even money can't fix.
I like this.
Forever in debt with my granny, cause she was there. Crack on gates for my homies on them tears. Still a strike, cause turn a hunt down your game. Try to last long, give a fuck about no race.
Lord, right?
I ain't beat up that case. Forever was shine, forever spin if they play. And life goes on without you if you ain't here.
So we're here. I feel like you've been, you reached out because you're filming a documentary. Which is like perfect timing.
For sure.
Because everyone wants to know what Lil Pete is up to. What, like, where's he been? Why doesn't he drop a lot? Like, I just want to get that off for the fans, like off rip. Like, what is it thought out? Or are you just kind of.
I ain't gonna lie. I'm like, what I be telling people, like, not even like that. Like, I don't, like, I really don't, like, when I wake up, I don't feel like a rapper. Like, so I like. No, I apply myself different. I be worrying about the wrong shit when I should be, but I don't know. Everything happened for a reason, so. I feel like I'm cool at the pace I'm going and where I'm at because what I've been doing, so. But you know, I'm hella prideful, too, so I be stuck in my ways, like, so. But I ain't gonna lie, I could do more music, like, music shit that I be, like, passing on. I be passing on, like, a lot of opportunities and shit.
Yo, let's get it.
This is pain at the San Francisco County Jail. This call is from a correction facility and is subject to monitoring and recording. To accept this free call, press 0. To refuse this free call, hang up or press 1. Thank you for using Global
Telling. The Vance. You doing, V. Started over you, you jump station, made a run. Thugging in the slum, smallest nigga with a gun. When my brother got shot, I showed my brother how it's done. They shot me 4 times, my brother pulled a murder one. Niggas posted hanging out like my brother wouldn't come.
Oh, keep behind it. You can ask G, cause he know I'm coming. And you can ask the niggas in the cell. If I send hundreds, if I'm mine, then I'm down. All my bitches love me cause I'm real as they come. I'd rather be dead before I fake before I lose. You mean cause I'm shining when I open door for me. I'm grateful for your favors, all they have to do for me. I'm such as whoever they ever try to tell me.
Like, what do you want people to see?
Kind of like on the inside of my life. You know, like I'm a regular person, just like, you know, my fans and shit. So I just wanted to show people, like, give them a little insight. You know, I'm not really with the content shit, like, you know, the lives and doing all, like, the corny shit. So I'm just like, man, I got to give them something. Because it's like, you know, people just thinking, like, oh, man, this bro even human? Like, he don't do shit. He don't pop out. I don't see him, like. So it's like, man, I gotta give him something. Like, you know, I live a regular life just like other people. So, you know, I go sport, I go gamble. You know, I might go up to Reno, go to Vegas. I sports bet. So it's like, you know, I play basketball on the daily. I go to the gym. You know, I be trying to be like on my health and shit. But nah, really just showing people, like, you know, that I'm a regular person. I do regular shit.
Paid like 30,000 for this, 35,000, 30,000, 20,000 for this. I bought this probably like 5 years ago. Paid 15,000 for that. AP, bought it for 60. Broly, I paid $50,000. This piece I bought it during EDD. Izzy made it. I paid like $40,000. This big Cuban, I paid $35,000. And the gold went up, so it probably value like. Like 42, 45,000 now, so our gains for value in the gold.
So this is like $300,000 in jewelry.
for sure. And these earrings right here. This is like $30,000 earrings. 2 carats from each ear. I got the GIA certified.
Free money. Gang, okay? No.
Watch this, nigga.
Let it on 10 or 4.
What happened? Listen,
we don't need no
10 or 4.
We don't got no money.
Listen, man.
10 or 4.
You can't tell a nigga not to say
that. I don't want to hear your son trying to got no money.
Let it on 10 or 4.
Yeah, I carry it. This is awesome.
Stop right here. This is the top of the fold. Like I said, I couldn't be outside. My pops was on me. My pops drove the muni bus, so if he caught me outside, he stopping the bus and he on me. So over here, I was cool because this bus, the buses that he drove never came over here. So
really in jail, so it's like ain't too many niggas out here. We being stopped, really chilling over here because the police, they like fucking on niggas, jacking niggas and shit. We be trying to stay away from the hood because the police, they on our dick and shit. So we be chilling. We don't really get into them for real. We only try to come over here and say what's up to our loved ones and shit. You don't really see nobody hanging around no more because this shit over with. Look at these abandoned buildings and then look how the hood used to be. Like, this shit ain't the same no more. So,
you know, when I couldn't go outside and film, this is where I had to go to fuck with all my cousins. Free boo, free socks, free grease.
Free
my nigga Buddha, man.
Yo!
This is a trap house. I ain't gonna lie. Growing up, niggas for sure used to have hella these. Niggas when it's cold, freezing cold.
Yeah, below 30. Yes, chilling, smoking, getting high.
It don't look like this though. We be having the player ones, little couches, little mini fridge and shit. Power still work, water still work.
Dice
catting off.
Dice games to the sun come up.
I'm a mama.
We used to get kicked out the house, couldn't go home. This would be right here for the sun come up.
We definitely got a trap around the hood. Every time.
Put the board back up, close it.
Act like we never broke in so housing don't come back and staple the door back in.
Man, this shit is fucked up, man. They trying to take this shit down. Too many memories up here. My auntie used to live in this house, so I grew up in that house.
300.
We used to have to sneak out the house, run down the cement hill.
You know, if you ain't never slid down the cement hill, you're not. You ain't never grew up over here, you don't know nothing. You do not
get on.
Oh boy, stunner.
I've never been in
private. You wasn't a stunner,
Jerry? Is that two-tone? Just rose gold straight?
No.
Shit cold.
You gotta be famous to take pictures right here. This a famous spot right here. Right here, just take a flick right here. You got the right cow here. Palace, all type of shit. Put your hands on the neck, 60.
Bands on the neck, R for my little brother BR.
Man, this shit mean a lot to me. Nigga really grew up here, bro, like I said. My dad and my mom, they didn't let me go outside where we lived because we lived in Fillmore, so I used to have to come to my cousin's house and hang out and shit. So this shit really a part of my life, for real.
Central, the sea level, family on this home right here, the corner, for since the 1940s. So my grandfather and grandmother, they migrated from Texas, and they bought this home with their family, with their, my grandfather's mother, my grandfather's brother, and his family. So they bought this fourplex right here at the corner. Maybe in the 40s, it was maybe for like about 60,000. Houses worth 3 million right now. If I was blessed to come home, and then I think like the second week of me being home, he took me to Vegas, and we were in the mall walking around there. And it was just like surreal, because I was just seeing people just coming up to him, asking them for autographs, taking pictures, and all like, damn, this shit crazy. He really did, you know, he really didn't touch me. This is out of state, so I was like, man, he touching lives, and you know, he recognized something, man. I was proud to see that. I was, it was definitely sweet to see. It was crazy because I was fighting my RICO case, you know, the county jail in San Francisco, and you know, people would be coming in and out of jail, and then they'd be coming in and they telling me like, man, I hear your son doing music, man, he's real nice, he's tight, you know, I like his music, you know, everybody on the streets is vibing to it. So it was a surprise to me. So when I called him, you know, he real laid back and humble, so he would downplay it. And I asked him about it, like, you know, I hear you doing music, man, what's up with that? And he was like, no, it ain't nothing, Dad. You're just doing it for fun. And I said, shit, I hear you pretty good. Like, are you doing numbers out there? So you better take this shit serious. And people are really out here liking you. And then, you know, it just carried on from there. And next thing you know, he has millions of views and all type of music execs and labels trying to, you know, sign him, get him on their label. So, you know, I'm proud of him. And yeah, you know, I'll just stay in his ear, just tell him to stay humble and, you know, keep pushing.
Finish it. And we ain't done, you know what I'm saying? We still got some more work to do.
No, for sure.
You know what I'm saying?
And 6 albums in 7 years. He doesn't think he's done a lot, but that's consistency for sure.
Yeah, he's staying at his craft, you know. Because you can't compare what you do to somebody else and how they make music. You gotta make it at your pace.
Babe, this right here, I didn't hit for a few times. I didn't hit 10,000 right here. This part, Alamo Square.
These the houses right here from Full House.
Police right here.
Get the police. It's the field, we told you, it's the cram, niggas hit over here like a motherfucker.
Nah, it's
tourism church.
It's gentrified for real. Right here.
Tucson.
It's the hood right here.
Look how fast we make to the hood.
It's never really left, though. They drive like a Samaritan, too. I'm gonna tell you where to slow down, too. It's the little hoop court I used to hoop right there every day when I lived up here. I lived here from like 1 to like 5 or 6.
It's my fault.
Used to play all throughout here. Couldn't leave out these gates. Keep going. Better have to stop, right? Right here. I used to live right here. This is my house. Like 1 year old to 5. Right there. Page Street, Rose Street.
That's the Rose Street street sign right here.
Make it right. Culture Center. I recorded a song there before when I was like a kid. This is how I used to live at. When I moved from up there, I moved like 5 blocks down. It's a whole different hood. Friendship, it's the Mac block. I used to play, it was like a little basket hoop thing, and I used to hoop right there. All night I used to hoop up there. I lived right here, 856 Webster Street. Right there. When I was a kid, bruh. My big bro, CJ, he passed right here, right outside my window. That was like the first time I ever seen something like that. Just a body laying right here. Here, I used to hear gunshots every night, and the firehouse is right there. So I used to hear the sirens all day, every day. After I moved from there, I lived in here.
You got the flag football right here. So I lived in that house. 856, then I moved 1047.
Up here.
I was playing a park every day. Like flag football. Over there, we used to play basketball. Real childhood memories here, man. My nigga Cease lived right there. My boy Rose, my next door neighbor. And he's legendary back here. My cousin Snow used to live right there. And these things right there. I know so many people that lived in here. Bring back memories right here. I ain't been down here in years. I moved from over here from like 13. And I was like 12, 13 years old. So from here to 13, I was living right here. I was born. Used to ride my little moped, dirt bikes back here. Should bring a lot of memories, man. These kids playing, we used to play just like that.
What is that?
Yeah,
That's something to
do. Cool. Oh, yeah. My dad had the keys to the gym. He used to work there, so I used to train basketball all day, all night. Had the keys to the gym. Sometimes hooping at 12, 1 o'clock on school nights. Legendary shit. Kinda stop right here. I got a lot of partners from here. It's the second hood right here. These are my stomping grounds. It's like my playground. Look at that. I love these niggas down here. These are my boys. Fuck what I'm having.
Oh, that's the same demo?
Yeah, that motherfucking dog keep tearing y'all niggas up.
What these chase blood niggas out here? You want? Huh? You want? You should be wanting them niggas to lose, though, ye. Might as well get home field advantage. Why would you be going for them niggas?
God.
Oh yeah, Chop. Chopping City, man, that's town. That's where I grew up at, man. The neighborhood. These my stumping grounds. Community City, man. Long nights out here. Understand me. Now, this ain't what you want. This ain't what you want.
All right, we got some true heat in the building. Make some noise, y'all. Make some noise. Millions of plays.
I be doing what I want, doing what they don't.
But they never understand me. Hey.
This ain't what they want. This ain't what they want. Free my niggas, free the gang, okay? No, no. Free my niggas, free the gang, okay? Niggas change it for these hoes, I can't. Get the money and the fame tonight. Keep it 100, stay the same, it ain't.
Link on the track.
Got a bad bitch with me, finna count it up. Heard my niggas just hit, we finna count it up. Heard my niggas came home and they counted up. Heard you broke up in your feelings, you can't count it up. Get broke, bounce back and I count it up. Heard they counting me out, so we gon' count it up. All my bitches by the check, tell them to count it up. I'm about to check too, so we counting up. Police try to stop me and I ran him, nigga. I ain't fucking with these hoes, I send you. Nigga say he bent the block, well, we bent too. All my niggas, yeah, they with it, yeah, they loose screws. So don't try nothing and nigga make the front news.
A hoe gon' be a hoe, I ain't mad at you. Told my secrets, told me lies, I ain't mad at you. You fucked another nigga, I ain't mad at you. Heard you choosy like you Susie, I ain't mad at you. You twerking for some likes, I ain't mad at you.